Hello YouTubers, it's me, Drifty Austin Servo, and today I want to talk to you about my love story. Well, as some of you know, I am a friend's victim, my family is, and my story started June 10th, 2008, and when my mom's gas was shut off, they did be safe and a safe side to get if I did get this far, but no one knew it would. So, 2 times the guy got shut up, I didn't think it would get to our house. I thought, I'd be without a warm bath even for a few days or so. Not tough. I don't know, so many people will try to keep me flat victims. So I can stand with this cold bath. I done it when I first moved in. But it would be worse from there. June 11th, 2008, in the morning, I woke up a little early, couldn't go back to sleep, and I just had a bad feeling that we're going to get evacuated. Well, behold, around 7:30, I knocked on the door. Soon I saw the door, because we had that window on top so we could see who was knocking. I knew we were getting evacuated before we even opened the door. So I opened the door, and lo and behold, we got evacuated. So we took 3 of our pets and some things. We took the cats to the Humane Society, and we took them ourselves and moved into our grandma's house. We left 4 pets behind, thinking that if that wouldn't get so bad, and like room in the car, even though the flight won't get too bad. People were in cages, we just took the cages high, thinking they'll be okay. So we left 4 pets, Peaches the cat, Speedy the turtle, Mary the llama, and Val the rabbit. We thought they would be fine. That night, about 5:36 or so, p.m., something like that, I thought I had bad feelings, like I should have put the 4 pets in the attic or something. Of course, 5:36, by the time we got in the car, got in there, it'll be close to 6, and then evacuation order noise was at 6, so we didn't have much time. So I put it in my mind, it's too late for that, they'll be fine. But we watched the news, and we fell alive, during the flood, and the question, higher and higher and higher. I knew our house was affected. I was just praying and hoping to God that they were okay. By the night, it crested at 31.2 feet. Which is unprecedented. It was far less than 93, far less than anyone imagined. We ended up having, like, so far, 72 houses had to be demolished because of the pump attack, because the arms were unsafe. We were building stuff. It's just too unsafe. Luckily, the house was yellow. So, that Monday, during the week, I went ahead. And I made calls to, hey, I got people that were rescuing pets, so I knew on cats, pets were affected. I told them, I gave them a description, told them, please rescue my pets. Later that week, I didn't know that week, but after the flood, that week, next week, we were about, third week of June, I can't think of the date right now, we were able to go to Kirkwood and see which pet, if our pets were there. I came there Wednesday. Peaches was there. Peaches survived. In fact, Peaches was on a video on KCRG. If I would have paid, because we didn't watch the news all the time, but most of the time we did. If I would have paid attention to that video, I would have known Peaches was okay. So we got there, Peaches fine. So we picked her up, she could get her grandma's house into her garage. And we saw this turtle there. Mom, I think that turtle's Speedy. I was like, no, she just can't be. She just can't be. The cage is different and the rock's still. That's not all. So she's a little too big to be a turtle. Then I'm looking at its mom, it wasn't her. So I put that, like, oh my neck, so close to Speedy, but it wasn't Speedy. Thursday, I came back myself to see if Mary fell and Speedy was there. They weren't also a thing for the turtle. Saw the same turtle. Thought to myself, could it be her? Nah, it can't be. That Saturday, I got a call, and you know the turtle in the cage, and the rocks, and stuff? It was her. It was Speedy. They just mixed form, and realized it was her. So we came back to Cookwood Saturday, picked Speedy up. But I knew by then, just that Marion's father was alive, was lame. Because they told me Thursday that if they wasn't there by now, chances are they were dead. So So other than that, I think the last week of June was family. My mom was finally out in the house, and my mom wanted to go by herself because she knew she would get upset and she didn't want to see us if I see her cry. So she came in and we saw that unfortunately Mary fell, didn't survive the flood. They were all good, happy at our house, and somehow, I think what happens when the dresser moved, they fell off somehow. To this day, I'm still kicking myself. I would have known this flood wouldn't gotten this bad. I would have helped my mom take a single trip, but no one knew this flood would get so bad. We thought it would be okay. But after that, my mom, some family members, my granddad was on that Sunday. My mom told me to go to church. They had enough help and they didn't want me to be too upset. So I went to church, got the guy at the house out. So the dust got gutted. It was ready for repair. Of course, we sanitized it first. And then we got up. When we get the permits, they denied us permits because, get this, 6 inches of a house was in a 100-year plane. We didn't know about this. We didn't have flood insurance. They didn't make us get flood insurance. 6 inches of the property was in the 100-year plan. They wrote the whole lot was in a 100-year plan. And we get 51% damage back then. My mom was thinking about moving the house or getting a new one. She looked into how much it would cost to move, but realized it would be a whole lot of money. It would just be better to move to the new house. So we started house shopping again. First time in since 2001, I thought we never would have to do that again as a family, but we did. But first house we went to, it was bad. It's so, the repair work has to be done with the house, it's so big, it would be better to tear it down. It wasn't even in the flood. But after looking for some houses, we found one that was also flooded, but that was bad, and it was a 500-year thing, and we left it, so we bought it, repaired it, and that's where I am now. I hope you enjoy my flood story and what else? But that's all. Have a nice day.